Everyone loves a good lunar eclipse, right? Especially people who think that the moon is some kind of push notification telling us that the end of days is coming? Oh, stop it! Happy Friday, Trace here with your DNews weekly space update. The moon is our celestial partner, twirling around us as we zoom around our star. It's a big hunk of rock made of dust and minerals with craters pockmarking its surface. It's a beauty, but it's not a harbinger of death and destruction. Next Tuesday, we're gonna have the first of four lunar eclipses over the next 2 years. When they're grouped like this, astronomers call them a tetrad, which means a set of four. Tetrads are four successive full eclipses with no partial eclipses in between. Lunar eclipses are not as rare as you'd think. Universe Today points out that there were 81 in the 20th century alone, with five tetrads. The 21st is gonna have 85 eclipses and eight tetrads. There hasn't been eight since the 9th century. Get pumped! Really, get pumped. A lot of these eclipses are partial eclipses, but a full lunar eclipse happens when the moon passes through the shadow of the Earth. It's always happening during a full moon because that's the only time we're between the sun and the moon. The Earth is kind of fat, but not so big as to completely black out our astronomical BFF. Instead, it gets kind of this rusty color. Why is that? Is it the blood moon from Revelation? Is the end nigh? No. No, it's not. Right. Anyway, so the moon's got red on it. As the moon passes on the other side of the Earth, our shadow will block the light from the sun. It won't appear totally black because the Earth is too far away and the sun is just too bright. When the sun's light hits our atmosphere, the colors of light are scattered by all of those little air molecules. Because of its long wavelength, red light is scattered the least, so it makes it through our gas to hit the moon. It's the same reason the moon appears orange or red when it's low in the sky, or sunsets are predominantly orange or red by the horizon, then blue and purple higher up. The red light makes it through all those miles of atmosphere to get to your eyes, while the blue scatters much higher. This is why we have blue skies too. Think of this full lunar eclipse like one giant sunset. Naming the moons is a tradition stretching back into ancient history. Without electrical lights, the movement of the stars, planets, and our moon was observable by pretty much everybody. So stories were told to explain their movements. A blue moon is two full moons in the same calendar month. Harvest moons appear nearest to the autumnal equinox, and the hunter's moon is the next full moon after that. Hunter's moons are also called the blood moon because it was a good time to shoot migratory birds. The internet has turned this into a crazy apocalyptic thing, but in reality, it's just a beautiful sight for astronomers. Want to add more pop cult sci-fi to this? Of course you do. Total lunar eclipses mean that the sun, the Earth, and the moon are all in alignment. That's called syzygy, by the way. It's a real word, a great word for Scrabble. Plus, as an added treat, Mars is going to be to the right of the moon as you look at it, too. This eclipse on April 15th will be the first of the next two-year tetrad. If you're in Asia and Europe, sorry, you're not going to be able to see it. But if you're in North or South America, we will be able to see it without a telescope, obviously, though if you have one, get it out, bro. It should be spectacular to see. The eclipse will start around midnight Pacific time, so look up where it's gonna start for you. Have you ever seen an eclipse? Are you gonna see this one? You can tell us about it down below or subscribe for more DNews. Speaking of down below, birth control is pretty common now and standardized, but what about before they had the pill and people had no idea what they were doing? Some ladies were even sticking lemons up there.
According to an ancient Jewish text, when life gives you lemons, you're supposed to insert them in your vagina so that the citric acid can act as a spermicide.
Citrusy fresh, sure, but not much good at contraception. You want to know some other crazy ancient birth control methods? Click right here. Watch this new show that I'm helping out with called Anywho. It's awesome, and it's really good, and it's awesome. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Bye.